Thank you for introduction. I'm Takashi Yamakawa from the University of Tokyo and IST. Today I'm talking about the adversary dependent lossy transfer function from hardness of fracturing thin smooth RC subgroup module. This is a joint work with Shota Yamada, Goichiro Hanoka, and Nobuko. So the main topic of this work is lossy transfer function, LTDF for short. LTDF was first introduced by Picard and Waters in 2008, and it is known that LTDF can be used for constructing various kinds of primitives, such as collision-resistant hash function, CC secure public key encryption, oblivious transfer, deterministic public key encryption, selective opening attack public key encryption, and so on. On the other hand, it is also known that LTDF can be constructed based on various kinds of assumptions, such as DDH, LWE, QR, DCR, and so on. So LTDF can be seen as a core primitive in cryptography, and so it is an important research topic to study more on LTDF. So this is a definition of lossy transfer function. LTDF is defined as a pair of functions of two modes, injective mode and lossy mode. In the injective mode, a function is injective and invertible efficiently by using a trapdoor. On the other hand, in the lossy mode, a function is lossy. That is, the image size of the function is much smaller than the domain size. And in that case, it is information theoretically impossible to invert the function. And additionally, we require indistinguishability of these two modes. This means that a function generated in injective mode and lossy mode are computationally indistinguishable. If these properties are satisfied, then we call the scheme is lossy transfer function. So this is our motivation. Although there are many known constructions of lossy transfer function, until now there is no known construction of LTDF solely based on the factoring assumption, which claims that it is hard to factorize a large composite number. There are some known factoring related construction of lossy transfer functions. However, all of them are based on stronger decisional assumptions such as QR, DCR, DRC, phi hiding, and so on. Compared with these assumptions, the hardness of factoring is much more classical and reliable assumption. So hopefully, we want to have a construction of LTDF solely based on the factoring assumption. This is the motivation of our work. And this is a summary of our result. Unfortunately, we couldn't construct LTDF based on factoring assumption. However, we took a step toward the goal. In particular, we first relaxed the notion of lossy transfer function, LTDF, to define which we call adversary dependent lossy transfer function, AD-LTDF for short. And we showed that AD-LTDF are still sufficient in many applications of LTDF, such as collision-resistant hash function, CPA public key encryption, and deterministic public key encryption. And then we constructed AD-LTDF based on the factoring assumption for semi-smooth RC subgroup module, SS module for short, which is a special type of RC module. As a result, we obtained the first construction of deterministic public key encryption based on factoring. And we, as a side result, we also constructed CC secure public key encryption scheme with compact ciphertext. So from now, I will explain the details. So first, I will explain how to relax the notion of lossy transfer function to define adversary dependent lossy transfer function, AD-LTDF. AD-LTDF is also defined as a pair of injective mode and lossy mode. However, in AD-LTDF, lossy mode is indexed by some index I. And we require, in the injective mode, the function is injective and invertible by trapdoor as well. And in the lossy mode, for any index I, the function is lossy, and so the image size is much more than the domain size. However, the indistinguishability is defined a bit differently from the usual LTDF. For the indistinguishability of AD-LTDF, we require that for any polynomial time adversary, there exists index I such that two modes are indistinguishable by that adversary. In this definition, what is important is that the index I can depend on the adversary. And so this means that the generation algorithm of lossy function can depend on an adversary. In this meaning, we call this notion adversary-dependent lossy transfer function. So it seems that AD-LTDF is a significant relaxation of the usual notion of LTDF. However, we show that AD-LTDF are still sufficient for many applications of LTDF. This can be seen by the following reason. In many applications of LTDF, lossy functions appear only in security proofs, and they often don't be used by the real construction of protocol. In that case, in security proofs, we construct a reduction algorithm by using adversary, and so the construction of a reduction algorithm can depend on the adversary. So if lossy function is only used by reduction algorithm, lossy function can depend on an adversary. So in such cases, AD-LTDF can be used instead of LTDF. So AD-LTDF is still useful. Okay, then now I'm talking about how to construct AD-LTDF from the factoring assumption for ACC module. To do so, we introduce a new assumption which we call AD-DRS assumption, adversary dependent decisional RS assumption. And we will show that the AD-DRS assumption can be reduced to the factoring assumption. And we also show that we can construct AD-LTDF based on the AD-DRS assumption. As a result, we obtain an AD-LTDF based on the factoring assumption for ACC module. So now I will explain the notion of semi-smooth RSA subgroup module, ACC module, which we use in this work. ACC module N is written as N equal capital P capital Q equal 2P P prime plus 1, 2Q Q prime plus 1, where capital P capital Q P prime Q prime are distinct primes, and P and Q are smooth numbers. That is, they are products of small primes. And in this work, we assume that all these primes are LB bit, where LB is order of log lambda. And for an ACC module N, the group of quadratic residue denoted by QRN is a cyclic group of order PQ, P prime, Q prime, and can be written as a direct product of two groups, G and G pap, whose orders are P prime and P prime, Q prime, and PQ, respectively. And we will use two facts about ACC module. The first one is that a partial discrete logarithm can be solved efficiently when given factorization of N. This is because the order of the group G pap is smooth, and so it is easy to solve the discrete logarithm on that group. And the second property is that if we pick G uniformly from QRN, then the distribution of G to the P1, P2 to P capital M is uniform on G, where P1, P2 to P capital M is all LB bit primes, and so capital M is the number of all LB bit primes. And I will introduce the DRS assumption, which was introduced by Gross. This assumption is a kind of subgroup decision assumption with respect to ACC module. And this assumption states that a random element of QRN is indistinguishable from a random element of its subgroup G. Equivalently, for ACC module N, this assumption can be stated like this. When G is uniformly sampled, the distribution of G and G to the P1, P2 to P capital M are computationally indistinguishable. This assumption was used in previous work. Shui et al. Constructed LTDF based on this assumption. However, this is a kind of subgroup decision assumption, and we don't know how to reduce this assumption to the classical factoring assumption. So their construction that is not factoring based construction. Our focus in this work is to construct on construction based on solely based on the factoring assumption. So we consider more relaxed adversary dependent version of the DRS assumption. So this is the definition of adversary dependent DRS assumption which we introduce. The AD DRS assumption is parameterized by some integer m, which is smaller than capital M, and the MAD DRS assumption states that for any PPG adversary, there exists a choice of m tuple of LB bit primes P1 to PM such that the distribution of G and G to the P1, P2 to PM are indistinguishable. And because these m primes are chosen out of capital M LB bit primes, so there are many choices, there are many possible choices of these primes. And each choice of P1 to PM gives a subgroup of QRN. So this assumption states that for any adversary, there exists a subgroup of QRN such that a random element of that subgroup is computationally indistinguishable from a random element of QRN. And what is important is that that subgroup can depend on the adversary. In this meaning, we call this assumption adversary dependent DRS assumption. So from now, I will talk about these two reactions. And first, I will talk about this part because this part is a little simpler. So as mentioned earlier, in our previous work, there is a construction of usual LTDF based on the usual DRS assumption. And actually, our construction is a slight modification of their construction. And we will prove this theorem. AD LTDF exists under the MAD DRS assumption for sufficiently large M. The first, well, we review the construction of usual LTDF from usual DRS assumption in the previous work. The construction is given like this. And why is this lossy transfer function? Correctness can be seen by the fact that partial discrete logarithm is solvable given the factorization of n, and so this is invariable. And lossiness can be seen by the fact that the description of the lossy function is g to the p1, p2 to p to the p capital m, which belongs to g. And g is a much smaller group than qrn, and so lossiness also holds. And indistinguishability is actually the DRS assumption itself. So these three properties are satisfied, and so this gives the LTDF. So next, I am talking about how to modify the construction to obtain AD LTDF from the AD DRS assumption. This is the construction of our scheme, and the difference from the previous construction is lossy mode. In AD LTDF, lossy mode is indexed by some index I, and in our construction, index I is given as a m-tuple of LB bit primes P1 to PM. And the lossy description of the lossy function is given as g to the P1, P2 to PM. And we show that this is actually AD LTDF. This is actually very similar to the previous one. The correctness is exactly the same as the previous construction. And lossiness is almost similar. Because g to the description of lossy function is g to the p1 to pm, and this belongs to a subgroup gi of qrn, where the subgroup gi is defined by index I equal p1 to pm. And if m is sufficiently large, then we can show that the order of the group gi is small, and so if in that case, we can show lossiness. And for indistinguishability, actually this is the indistinguishability is actually the MAD DRS assumption itself. So these three properties are satisfied. So now we obtained AD LTDF from the AD DRS assumption. Next, I'm talking about how to reduce the AD DRS assumption to the factoring assumption for ACS module. AD DRS assumption is a kind of subgroup decision assumption. On the other hand, factoring assumption is a such assumption. So it seems very difficult to reduce this assumption to functional assumption. So this part requires a new idea, and this is actually a technical core of our work. So we will prove this theorem. The MADDRS assumption holds under the functional assumption for sufficiently small m. So now we recall the definition of MADDRS assumption. This assumption says that for any PPT adversary, there exists an m-tuple of LB bit primes P1 to PM such that the distribution of G and G to the P1, P2 to PM are computationally indistinguishable. So if this assumption is broken, then this means that there exists a PPT adversary which distinguishes these two distributions for any choice of LB bit primes P1 to PM. From now, I will construct a factoring algorithm based on this adversary. If this is done, this means that the MADDRS assumption is reduced to the factoring assumption. So from now, I will describe the description of factorizing algorithm. Factorizing algorithm is given a composite number n, and as a first step, it generates two lists, L and L prime. It sets L as all LB bit primes, and L prime to be an empty set. And as a step two, while the size of L is larger than or equal to M, it repeats the following. It first chooses M tuple of LB bit primes P1 to PM from L randomly. And then, for this P1 to PM, because we assume that this adversary breaks the MADDRS assumption, this adversary distinguishes these two distributions. And by the hybrid argument, there exists I such that the adversary distinguishes the distribution of G to the P1, P2 to PI minus 1, and G to the P1, P2 to PI. And for such I, the factorizing algorithm removes PI from L and add PI to the other list L prime. Here, I remark that we have PI divided phi of n with overwhelming probability. Because otherwise, the distribution of G to the these two distributions are exactly equivalent, and any adversary cannot distinguish these distributions. So we have PI divided phi of n. And repeat this procedure while the size of L is larger than or equal to m. So when this step finishes, the size of L becomes m minus 1. And the total number of LB bit prime is capital M. So at that point, the size of L prime is capital M minus M plus 1. And then the factorizing algorithm at the step 3 computes the total multiple E of prime contained in L prime. Because all primes contained in L prime divide phi of n with overwhelming probability, so the multiple E of them also divides phi of n with overwhelming probability. And L prime contains capital M minus M plus 1 LB bit prime. So the multiple of these primes, E, is larger than 2 to the capital M minus M plus 1 times LB minus 1. Here, it tries to factorize N by using Coppersmith method. Coppersmith method in our scenario means that given E such that E divides phi of n, and E is larger than square root of n, n can be factorized efficiently. And we already have E divided phi of n with overwhelming probability, and E is larger than 2 to the capital M minus M plus 1 times LB minus 1. And we show that M is sufficiently small, then E is larger than square root of n, and so the Coppersmith method can be used, and n can be factorized. So by this way, we show that the MADDRS assumption can be reduced to the factoring assumption. So by now, we proved these two theorems. The first one says that AD-LTDF exists under the MADDRS assumption for sufficiently large m. And the second one says that the MADDRS assumption holds under the factoring assumption for sufficiently small m. So, and we show that there exists a choice of M such that both theorems are applicable. So by choosing such M, we can combine these two theorems and obtain our main result. State that AD LTDF exists under the factoring assumption for SS module. In the actual proof, we have to set parameters carefully. So for the detail of this point, please refer to our paper. Well, next, I'm talking about application of AD LTDF. As mentioned earlier, in many applications of LTDF, we can replace LTDF with AD LTDF in collision release hash CPA PKE deterministic public encryption. And in those schemes, especially, we construct the first deterministic public encryption scheme that satisfies the security notion defined by Bondi-Lebor et al. Under the factoring assumption. I will not give the detail of our construction. However, our scheme can be obtained simply replacing the LTDF with AD LTDF in the previous construction. And besides direct application of AD LTDF, by using a similar technique, we construct CC secure public key encryption scheme based on the factoring assumption for SS module, whose ciphertext overhead is the shortest among schemes based on the same assumption. And in particular, the ciphertext overhead of our scheme consists of one group element and one MAC. And the construction of our scheme is a variant of CCCA secure chem from hash proof system proposed by Hofheinz and Kiels. Intuitively, we instantiate the construction based on the AD Dirac assumption. So this is a summary of my talk. This is the end of my talk. Thank you for your attention.